because we're gonna go live on YouTube channel too. That's the YouTube channel, voted number one pizza channel on YouTube. You can learn from your house everything. If you have any problem, how to cook, how to make the pizza, how to stretch, go on YouTube channel and you'll learn everything for free. Woo-hoo! No, I'm saying for free.
Free.
Yes.
Free.
How long for YouTube? How long? Are we live? Okay, guys, welcome back to my channel. And here we are in Las Vegas with a lot of people. We're gonna make a pizza alla pala, show you from the scratch with Maestro Vincenzo Florio, together with me and Francesco Modugno.
Follow me on Instagram, Vincenzo Florio Pizza Chef.
Yes, so make sure you go on Instagram or follow my channel, Vito Iacopelli and Vincenzo Florio. And of course, go on YouTube and subscribe. Please, people, stop by and check this out because it's gonna be tasty. Tasty. Okay, let's go. Let's set up this microphone 1 second. Aspetta un attimo.
Ciao, Will.
Okay, we're gonna wait for more people to come a little bit. Come closer, come closer. We're gonna do a demo live here of pizza alla pala, and you guys are gonna be able to taste this this pizza in a little bit. We made a biga 100% like 1 hour ago, and now we about to make the pizza alla pala. You guys have any question? No, you know what's pizza alla pala? Nada. Pizza alla pala is a pizza a little bit long. Put in this is basically, you can serve it with slices. It's a little bit crunchy and soft at the same time. And then also, this is a pizza gourmet of Roma that we gonna, it's born here in the United States now, 2018. It's coming. So if you guys want to make pizza slice, you want to sell slice pizza, this is the way to go. Okay, so let's try to spiegare. Questa la passo nella chat. Okay, this is the dough made with biga. It got 36 hours of fermentation. Look how soft it is. 36 hours of fermentation and 80% of water. So we have 80% of hydration, so it's a very soft dough, because to make pizza alla pala you need to have a dough very, very soft. So now we're gonna show you. So basically you put the dough in a container with a little bit of olive oil under the dough. This way it doesn't stick. So let's go, let's start. So this is gonna be really interesting and tasty. Okay, come close and compact.
Are you ready?
You guys, I bet you guys have been tasting here around the place just a regular pizza. This is a different pizza. This is a different pizza. Crunchy and safe and soft in the same time. Look at this. Take a look at this dough. Come closer with this. Hold on a second. We're going to show. Check this out, how much air is this pizza and how soft it is. You need to touch gentle the pizza. Look at this, how it stretch. It's stretching. Basically, it's not stretching, it's pressing. Ecco qua, amici. Ecco la pala. Of course, we have a long peel. Hold on a second.
Gira.
Sorry, people, we have a camera, microphone, everything. Okay, so now you just press it. So like you can see, you just touch it, just gentle, very little. And now it's gonna make it long as the peel is. Però, Vincenzo, ma questa pizza la possono fare anche rotonda o no?
Anche rotonda,
sì. This pizza, you can also make a circle. but it's typical like this. So now, hold on, it's running, hold on. We're gonna explain why we put it in the oven. No, wait. Okay. So this is the pizza alla pala. Pizza alla pala needs to be cooked two times to make a little bit crunchier than the rest. So similar to the bread, but this is pizza. So we are going to put this in the oven. If they want to put some oil, se vogliono mettere un po' d'olio sulla pizza, si possono mettere. Lo mettiamo ora o dopo? Okay, in this case we're gonna put the oil later because we're gonna make a pizza gourmet alla pala. So now we're gonna go in the oven. The oven needs to be set at a low temperature. So about 600 Fahrenheit and about 300 degrees on top. And 300 Celsius. 300 Celsius. So at home.
120.
No. 300 Celsius. 300 gradi.
300 gradi nostri.
Yes. So it's about. About 550 Fahrenheit. So low temperature. Now we're gonna put it in the oven. Lo dobbiamo bloccare o dobbiamo girarlo? So this oven is rotated. So in a little bit, let's wait. Let's see how long. It takes. Let's see how long it will take to cook.
Questa è una prima fase di cottura. Andiamo a cuocerla per creare la gelatinizzazione dell'amido e poi la andiamo a farcire. Creeremo una base di pizza gourmet.
Aspetta, lo spiego in italiano. Che hai detto?
Che è una fase di precottura.
Okay, this is the first. This pizza, like I said before, this pizza needs to be cooked two times.
Gelatinizzare l'amido.
This is the first time, so we're gonna pre-cook the dough about gold color. It's checking the bottom. almost ready. The first cook. So like you can see, did you see how it's growing? Please take a look on the oven. If you can see, let me know.
Vito, esprime gli americani la pala, che cos'è?
La pala?
Shovel, Vito, shovel.
No, la shovel, this is a peel.
Yeah, vabbè, peel,
but
pala.
If you put pala on Google Translator, it's a shovel. I don't know why. I don't know why, but this is the peel. How you guys say this in English? The right term, peels, right?
Peel. Yeah.
It's the peel. But Google Translator is a shovel.
Okay.
Sì, aspetta. He's gonna say in Italian something, then I'm gonna translate for you.
Okay.
La pala viene chiamata così perché in origine era una pala di legno ed è stata e si è evoluta con la creazione di pale in alluminio.
A lot of years ago, the peel was only wood, and now they created something aluminum, so it's a little bit better. So if you get some bubbles like this big, you can make a hole. So almost there, guys. We're gonna create this pizza with a very, very fancy mushroom, which you can check it out here. Those mushrooms are really, really good to make this type of pizza. Vita Champ mushroom, and of course with the olive oil, which we have here. This is monodose oil. Monodose, come si dice monodose? Monodose in inglese? Monodose. Come si dice, Luca, monodose? Well, we have the right amount of olive oil. This is right here, so check it out. Grab a little bit. And then, of course, this pizza is made with Mulino Piantoni, which is my favorite flour. Yes, Mulino Piantoni is one of the best flour, 00. But to make this pizza, you can use a type 1, which is a little bit more strong. But you can also use a 00 flour. So if you pre-cook like this way, in this case, this is a 00. But I prefer to use type 1. It's a little more protein, a little bit more strong. Okay, this one is made with biga. Yes, we made 1 hour ago. We made a biga. The biga, I'm gonna show you to you.
50-50?
No, 10% of biga. This is the biga that we made. We made. No, this is biga. Lievito madre is one thing, and biga is one more thing. This biga we made 1 hour ago. And this dough is made with biga from 2 days ago, because this dough have 36 hours. Quante ore c'ha di fermentazione?
Questo c'ha 36 ore.
This dough is made with 36 hours of fermentation.
Invece del lievito c'ha un 50% di biga.
Oh, we made this dough with 50% of biga. Yes. No, no, la biga in the fridge.
No, no, quello.
This one outside.
Outside.
Sì. After you made the dough?
No, 36 ore fuori la fridge. In due passi.
No, see, this is after we made the dough, 16 hours outside the fridge. 16 hours.
Is it okay?
1 second.
Is it okay to use baking paper for homemade pizza? Is it okay to use baking paper for homemade pizza?
Yes, it's okay for to use this baking paper to make this type of pizza. No, the biga needs to be rest in the fridge. Then you put the biga in the dough, you make the dough, and then it needs to be done for 16 hours outside. Simple. The piece is almost ready. Okay, the pizza is about to get out. Did you see? It's cooking in about 10 minutes. No, maybe less. We have about 10 minutes the first cook. La prima volta. La palla è bollente, cazzo. Scusate. Che mi sono bruciato. Vabbè. Okay, let's show the people here. Porca puttana, è calda. Okay, we're gonna show it to you.
Okay, take a look at this pizza. Show you. This is crunchy outside, but it's soft inside. So now we're gonna finish it as a pizza gourmet.
So this pizza is a gourmet pizza, pizza alla pala. This is something perfect to sell slice of pizza. Now we're gonna add this fantastic oil, monodosi. So this is extra virgin olive oil from Star Borges. Give me 1 second, aspetta che... Let me talk about this oil 1 second. Vieni, Giorgio. Because thanks to this company, here we are today, and I'm very glad to present to you this oil, because I really love it, and that I believe is perfect for pizza, any type of pizza or salad. Talk about a little bit this oil, where it come from.
Yeah, this extra virgin olive oil is coming from southern Spain. Its store is the leader in the West Coast in the USA, and these portion packs, we are the only company selling extra virgin olive oil in such a nice packaging. It's a neat packaging. We control our costs with that. It's a very convenient, very useful. And just a little drizzle of olive oil on your pizza or your salad. It's a very simple, tasteful. We have such other varieties like extra virgin olive oil with a spicy flavor. We have balsamic vinaigrette with the addition of a balsamic vinegar from Italy. So please enjoy the pizza Vito is cooking for us.
Thank you so much, Giorgio. And then if you're interested, also, so this pizza now that we put the olive oil, we're gonna put this fancy mushroom, but before you're gonna put the mozzarella.
Mozzarella, burrata, mushroom.
We're gonna put the burrata, mozzarella, and mushroom, and fancy tomatoes. So the mushroom also are really good. And then taste this pizza. If you like it, please take a business card next to us here and check it out. Olive oil and mushroom from Star Borges. Mushroom coming. Mushroom.
I
say something, you're gonna say, listen this, hold on. Dillo, dillo.
So in Italy we say, chi muore coi fungi, fessa chi lo piange. It's mean, if somebody die with mushrooms, stupid people are gonna cry.
Just as saying, these guys. Okay, I repeat, guys, check out my YouTube channel for free tips how to learn. Right there, look, Vito Iacopelli, number one pizza channel on YouTube. Subscribe, right there. Okay, la burrata, la burrata. Okay, we got burrata, cherry tomato. Now we're gonna put the best part, it's the mushroom, to complete this fantastic pizza, and then it's gonna go in the oven. Take a look at this pizza, please.
Sure.
Facciamolo vedere. I mushroom arrivano, arrivano da dove? Dalla Spagna arrivano? I'm gonna show to you, take a look one second, take a look of this pizza.
Beautiful.
Take a picture one second, take a picture and tag. Please, a round of applause for Maestro Vincenzo Florio. And check out him on Instagram, Vincenzo Florio Chef. Pizza chef. Well, that is not done yet. Yeah, it's not done yet. Stay here because you guys are gonna taste the mushroom is coming from where?
This nice mushrooms coming from the Netherlands. The Netherlands, Holland. The best country in the world.
Okay. So this
12-month crab grown indoor. We're talking about top-notch quality, okay?
So now he's adding the mushroom. Make it with F with mushroom, and then okay, more mushroom, perfect. So I hope you like mushroom, because this pizza with mushroom. Okay, did you see what he did? Hold on. We're gonna take a picture first, and a picture after. Scusami, possibile fare una foto qui? Hold on a second, take a picture for my friends on Instagram and YouTube.
1, 2,
paparazzi?
Thank you.
Take a picture of the pizza, please.
Can I get a picture of them?
So now that we're gonna put it in the oven again, so we're gonna give it a second cooked. That's the reason why this pizza is so we're gonna dry out this pizza to make it a little bit crunchy and inside. Aspetta, dove vai? La devi assaggiare. No, it takes 2 minutes to cook. 3 minutes to cook. So stay here. You stay here 15 minutes. We gotta taste the pizza, my friend. Where are you going? Look at this guy, man. It's okay. This is a light pizza. No, hold on. I'm going to answer to this guy about healthy pizza. Okay? Let's talk about healthy pizza. I go to the gym every day, but I eat pizza every day. But I eat healthy pizza. Okay? Because this pizza that we make here, fresh mozzarella, flour that comes from Italy, all good organic ingredients, makes the pizza. If it's a good fermentation and not just business, the pizza is really digestible. You don't feel full. If you feel full once you eat one slice of pizza, aspetta, io lo dico a te perché tu stai andando via. When you eat a pizza and after one slice you feel full, that means that the pizza was no quality or was made just to make money. Money is really important, but we make pizza because we love to make pizza and we make it good. But this pizza is very digestible. You can eat 2-3 slices, you don't feel full. That's for sure. It's made with 36 hours of fermentation. Round of applause, please. Thank you. Pizza is good for muscle today. It's good protein and good carbs. Fantastico. Allora, alzo le mani. Però deve assaggiare sta pizza. Okay, he's gonna stay with us. Like you old guys, you're gonna taste the pizza. I know you guys are 50 or we're gonna make a 50 slices. Almost ready.
1, 2, 3. Perfect.
You're gonna stay with us to taste the pizza? Okay, good. Okay, I repeat. This is a pizza alla pala, typical in Rome. Very typical. And if you are planning to make a slice of pizza, selling slice of pizza, and not only Neapolitan style, that's the way to go. Because this pizza is, you can sell a slice easily, quality slice of pizza. Make with premium ingredients. Please, after you taste the mushroom, olive oil, and everything, check out here to the right the mushroom, the olive oil, and everything, because these guys are amazing. That's why I'm here, eh? Okay, thank you. Oh, è pronta sta pizza? Arriva, arriva. It's coming out, 1 minute. Sono barese. Bari, Torramare. Sono Torramare. Fantastico. Quanti pugliesi ci sono qui? How many people from Puglia? Nobody. Oh, nessuno di pugliese qua. Who is from Los Angeles? Los Angeles, somebody from Los Angeles? Fantastic. Los Angeles, the city of angels. The city of the dreams. If you dream and you believe your dreams, you make it happen. Okay, the pizza is ready. Please, round of applause for Vincenzo Florio. Look at this. Take a picture. Take a picture. Adjust, adjust. Look at this. This is food porn. Fantastico. Hey, hey, take a look. Take a look at this jacket right on the back. Take a look at this jacket in the back. Hold on, hold on. Hi. Read, read.
Yeah, there we go. I got both of the...
Okay, anyway.
Un attimo di silenzio, un attimo di silenzio.
Oh, okay. Oh, listen to this. Listen to this.
Is there meat in there?
Crocante.
Did you see? The crocante. Hold on, hold on. Okay, we're gonna make 55 slices, yeah? Oh, 55 pezzi dobbiamo fare qua. Ci mangi già
50 sfumature di pizza.
Ah, 50. 50 shape of pizza. Ok, maybe Vincenzo, facciamo un'altra? Visto che sono tanti?
Sì.
Ok, hold on, hold on. We're gonna show the people here inside the dough. Take a look at this dough. Because we didn't do anything.
Aspetta, aspetta. Inside.
Beautiful. You guys should take a picture of this pizza inside. Beautiful. Look. It's all air. Take a look of inside, please. Did you see? You got some a lot of holes inside. That means that the fermentation was perfect, 36 hours. So look at this. Soft and crunchy in same time. That means outside is crunchy, inside is soft. Because if you make a whole crunchy, you're gonna break your teeth. So we're gonna make another one because you guys are so many here. Thank you so much for taking the time and stay with us. Please subscribe to my channel and come and taste the pizza. Okay, little by little, take a slice, ready to rock and roll. Please, guys, after round of applause, ask for making this pizza. Thank you, thank you. Really appreciate everyone.
Thank you.
Oh, people, who is here from Colombia? Nobody's from Colombia? We have a pizza place in Bogota. Napule Pizzeria by Vito Iacopelli. He is my partner here, and we are creating this new chain in Bogota. Oh, this is for me. Oh, it's for you.
Un saluto alla Pizzeria da Pietro in Cartagena de India.
Cartagena de India. Ok, Tovaglioli, 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 Rayer. No, Seattle, my friend, Los Angeles, time is money. If you stop one day, adios amigos. Who is from Los Angeles and knows what I'm talking about? Oh no, time is money, Los Angeles, no? Yeah, but Los Angeles, if you stop, the sharks eat you. Thank you so much for being here. Please, guys, come by and taste this pizza alla pala from Rome. We're gonna make more now, fancy, with some meat. Oh, in a little bit we're gonna make in 30 minutes we're going to make the pizza alla teglia. So if you are interested, swing by. Thank you so much. So what's your name? Guys, who is tasting this pizza? Please raise your hands and tell me how is it. It's good. Fantastic. Thank you so much. Viva la pizza dal maestro Vito Iacopelli e Vincenzo Florio. Thank you. Okay, we are making some more pizza alla pala. We are making more pizza alla pala and this way everybody can taste this fantastic pizza. Yes. For pictures, please come by now because later it's going to be tough.
Vito, ma posso stare sicuro con questi? Con questi qua, posso stare sicuro, no?
Where from?
Okay guys, thank you so much for watching. A little bit we are going to make a pizza alla teglia and go on my Instagram. Thank you so much and please thumbs up and subscribe. Ciao.